And that's it.
Yep.
And that's running for you. Great. Okay, to get into the aeroplane, just as I said, just only stand on the white. Once you're in, you can sit on the stand on the seat. That's not a problem. And then slide your feet into the footwell.
Yep.
There we go. And then I'll help you strap in.
All right.
Snug first and foremost, you'll find it. So you rest your feet on the pedals for me. That's it. So these are the first ones that go in. So that clips in on this side. And then what you do is you just tighten it up a little bit. You pull on the other side and then keep it centered. That. That's it. Doesn't need to be painfully tight. That one clips in the bottom. I'll let you do that. There you go. And then pull it down. Super. And then the shoulder straps come on over the top. You might want to put your collars up actually.
Yep.
So it will slide then and stop it catching on the skin. There you go. There you go. It's a bit tight. There you go. And then they clip in there.
And these ones are loose on
the yeah. They're on an inertia belt anyway, so that's looking pretty good actually. There you go. Good, you're in. All right, that's all set. I'll let you play around with that to get that set up. I think it needs the screen a bit more. Now, the last thing I want to give you is your headset.
Oh, yes.
Your headset is this one. I'll pop it down here. Don't worry about the cables there. But this goes on your left side, mm-hmm. and that needs to be close to your mouth.
Okay.
All right?
Perfect.
Right, I'll get the rest of the stuff ready, and I'll join you in the cockpit.
There you go.
Just for a moment, I'll get myself sorted. Rugby player, and you think, oh crikey, it's actually the leg size that's the limiting factor, mostly.
Oh,
you know, someone with big chunky thighs can be it can be quite a challenge to get them in. That's okay, right? That's done. Sorry, I'll stop that boy for a moment. Good. In, it's not too bad, it's just the getting it. It takes a little bit of time.
How old is the aircraft?
The aircraft is 1995, so it's 25 years old, which isn't that old really for airplanes. The Bulldog, which is our other airplane, was 1973. But actually, it's not done for, although it's a lot older, it's done. Significantly fewer flying hours because we got it from the Ghanaian Air Force, the Bulldog.
Oh, right.
And I think it'd been sat in the hangar for the best part of 30 years.
Oh, yeah.
So it's on it. So it was, so it's a nice airplane, the Bulldog. We'll see which one you get to fly on your next flight. We tend to use the Firefly just because it's a bit easier. That's my headset. So I'll pop that on. That's good. You won't be able to hear anything until I've got the power on, so don't worry about that.
Nope.
Just want to use this here when it's out the way. That's all good. I'll move that down there out the way for you. This is my moving map, which is super handy. Which is very clips on here. And then I know where I'm going all the time, you see. So
nice, I like that.
There we go.
Hello. Right, I'm going to close this. Stop the rain. You've got some door that you can open here. And then this is a cold vent, so you pull it out for lots of cold air, and you can steer your cold air to yourself there. Okay.
Right. So, can you hear me? Yes, you can. Good, I saw you jump. Lovely. Is it very noisy?
A little bit.
If it's very noisy, then what we can do with you is we can... Is that quieter for you?
Yeah, that's
better. Okay, all right, so let's leave it there. You might get a little bit, you might need a bit more volume when we're in the air, but that should be okay for now.
Yeah.
Okay, good stuff. Right, just mind your knee for me. Do a couple of checks here. That's good, that's good. That's fine. Set on the lowest, I'll set to the left. That's all good, that's all good. And we'll go 1, 2, 1, 8, 8. Okay, that's good. Right, let's talk to them. Good morning, Aeronaut 01, requesting start 2PLB 8.1. Sound rude, Aeronaut 01. Cool, so that's that done. I'm gonna turn that off and out. It's gonna get quiet, don't worry about it. That's all good, that's all set, that's all set. And we're clear to start. Just move that down there so it doesn't catch. Good, okay, so my checklist. Target brake, trim position, accelerometer, I did. And then all of this stuff. Internal inspection, cockpit, and other signs. First aid kit, fire extinguisher, baggage, rudder, bells, harness, headset, controls. Just mind your legs for me. One and three, no restriction. Cockpit lights, avionics, fuel pump, and alternator are all off. Good, master switch on, alternator one at check, intercom was done, Peter heat, that was all done off. Engage, that is all fine. That's all set to 1011. I'll set 1011 here, and that gives height above sea level for where we are at the moment. Ammeter is zero, positive charts all good. Ammeter static vent is closed. So throttle full and free, set idle, max RPM, set to cut off, check on parking brake on, flaps done, trims, canopy and propeller is clear. So for engine start, parking brake is on, beacon, nav lights, I won't do them just yet. Throttle half open, mixture fully rich, fuel pump. That's priming the engine. 5, mixture to cut off, throttle coordinate open. Good. Clear prop! That goes to both. And.
pressures on that camber?
No, no, no.
Good.
Fine.
So on the next flight, what you'll do is,
well, you seem fine.
You're a little bit nervous about the flight, but you seem absolutely fine then. In fact, I was almost tempted to do some aerobatics with you, some more, but actually, I would rather you landed from this one feeling happy. And then on the next flight, if you're feeling great, then at the end of the flight, just say, can I do something else?
All right.
Then I'd much rather you went into your next flight thinking, yeah. That's it. Good stuff.
But we give it quite a lot in the flight. We looked at the effects of controls.
So you saw that this is the angle of attack. Because that, the stick forwards and backwards, you could see straight away that relationship between lift and weight changing. And that's because of the angle of attack changes that you make on the aeroplane. This left and right is your rate of roll. It doesn't make you turn, it just makes you roll. So that's your rate of roll. And then the rudders, you feel quite heavy, and it's really uncomfortable when you're not flying in a straight line. You really notice it. That's it. We then looked at different speeds, and I think you felt noticeably different, didn't it, at the higher speeds. And then it feels a lot easier to control, it's a lot looser at the lower speeds. The slipstream effect, I think you really notice it when you go to idle power. Then you notice the difference in the elevator and the rudder. I think that's when, you know, full power to idle, you think, oh yeah, it feels lighter now without the slipstream. We looked at dihedral, and that worked quite well today. And we looked at spiral diving, and I could see you going, when's he going to stop this? When's he going to stop? Yeah, okay. So I didn't want to prolong it too long, but it would go all the way if you wanted it. We then had a look at the steep turn, so you felt a couple of G, and you could see how I was having to increase the angle of attack, increase the make extra lift to maintain a level turn or two. We did the spaceman stuff, so you had a little bit of a feel of Mars, a little bit of a feel of the moon, and then deep space. We did the barrel upside down. And then we did the stall turn, which you didn't like as much as the barrel. Good stuff. And then we finished off with an instruments approach, which we do very rarely here actually, but you saw the instruments work really well. In a small aeroplane like this, it's difficult, because any change you make, any change of power, affects this, affects this, everything, so you're going to be able to hit quite a lot of things. But what is that? Right, we're going to check out the end of the video. So, I should have to be ready to put your hands on the first. I'm going to turn the video off, it's going to get quite a bit of this on the seat. Stopped. Mixture's cut off, nav lights off, flaps 40, and I look at the fuel. I've got 60 and 40. 40 and 60, and the time is 34. And that goes off. Right, so you can take your headset off for me. Lovely job.
Thank you.
And then you can unstrap. While we're in the aeroplane, that's no problem. So what we'll do is we'll unstrap everything before I open the lid. So it's a twist. Everything comes away apart from that one. If you just want to let your shoulder straps go over your shoulder like that, that's great. And then once that's done, you can unclip the three buckles for your parachute like that. And then slide your arms through. That's it. And once you've done that, you just have to stand on your seat and ease yourself out of the aeroplane. And just remember, only stand on the white.
Yeah.
Oh yes.